Hello there and welcome to a brand new playthrough. The game's called Going Medieval and I've been waiting for quite some time to do a playthrough in this one. I'm gonna skip all the preparation, which is the menu, choosing the location, the map, the settlers and all that. So we're straight in the game. It's the morning of our first day. And yeah, if you have played RimWorld before, it's fairly similar. The interface over here, I'll go over it very quickly. Bottom right, different commands we can give. Top right is some information and notifications. Top left, just like RimWorld, we've got jobs, different priorities we can set on our people here. The schedule of when they work, sleep, eat, have fun. And then we can also manage what kind of weapons, shields, clothes, armor they use and wear. Then the last one is here, research and region, but we can't really use them until we build the right equipment. Then we also got a little preview of who's in our colony, so I've picked a few viewers from the audience and we'll go through them very shortly as well. And then in this section here, it tells us about some information about where our cursor is on the map. So for example, right now I can see that we've got some limestone. But if you move over, this is all grass, which might be quite good to put some crops down in this location. And bottom left, this is just the build menu of different things we can construct and put down here. Right, so let's get started with the game. Before we pause this, let's allow everything that we are gonna need here. And let's have a quick tour of the map as well. It took me quite a while to find something. I originally wanted to have a map with a large hill in the middle and everything else around, ideally lower, but it was just very, very difficult to find something I like, so I settled with this one. Right, now going around, it's quite an interesting map. We've got a somewhat of a central hill or a mountain here, and then on the right hand side there's a bit of a moat, which will be very handy to direct the people that we don't want to come into our colony around. So that's all those bad people that want to steal and attack us. And then same on this side as well. So what I was thinking when I was just having a quick look around is that we could build a castle or some sort of a colony right up here. And there's two options or three maybe what we could do, but we'll build it as we go along. And this could be like the grand entrance with some few towers and a bit of a wall around this as well. So that could be pretty cool. So let's have a quick look at our colonists as well. We got the good looking gamer leading our colony, and he's gonna be, well, we can only choose three colonists at the start with the settings that I went. And the good looking gamer, almost wanted to say beaver, that's a different game. All right, the good looking gamer, he's gonna be our scientist. He's been very helpful on both on YouTube and Discord with other members as well, so I thought he's gonna be a great leader for this colony in here. So and here's a few stats that he has as well. He's interested in botany and culinary as well, so could fill the chef's role for a little bit, but then he's gonna jump on the science for quite a bit. Then we have Bali Kiwi. Unfortunately, I couldn't fit your full names in here because there seems to be a character limit. But essentially, Pauly is going to be our master architect. And yeah, he's got some stats in both construction and mining. And then Pixie over here, he's going to be a bit of a artsy person. He's also going to help us out with some botany and help and with food. But then once we have the required technology, he will jump into smithing, tailoring, and creating a whole sort of fun stuff for us. Right, so that's the introductions done. Fortunately, it didn't take too long. The first thing we are gonna need, we shall give them a few orders to cut all this down. And I was thinking we might just, how shall we do this? Maybe we'll, now we're gonna build our starter colony here, and then we'll move out once we are ready. So next thing, I think the schedule we can leave it as is right now. We are gonna set them on 1, and let's see, we shall need... You were a scientist, so let's do 1 in here. And... for the time being, I think we're gonna need to cut some plants. Maybe 2 in here. Mining, I don't think, but construction is gonna be very important as well. So let's do that. Oh yeah, and we would like to... Let's see, I think Pixie was our melee. Yep. So Pixie... Let's give you a shield. And the other 2 were ranged. Great. No headgear. Let's do all headgear. And I think Pixie is gonna be the one that will need armor. Yes. Weapons. You know what? Just go all weapons for the time being. That's fine. Right. Alright, so let's cut away. We'll speed up the time just a little bit. We'll create a bit of space here. And I think we could put some buildings nice and close over here. Yes, so let's bring up the building menu. We've got some wood now. Let's see. Yep, that should be fine. So the first few things we are gonna need is somewhere for them to sleep. So we'll create a nice little house. How many? We'll use these sticks for the flooring. Let's do something like that, I suppose. And let's see, we've got the hay sleeping spot. Do we have any hay? Yes, we do have a little bit. Okay, so let's put a stockpile right underneath all this stuff here for now, so we can at least get a quick tally of what we have. And for that, I think we can do... This should be sufficient for our needs for the time being. So this is gonna be the sleep house. Let's put a door on here as well. And if we have a quick look at furniture, we're gonna need a few beds. So let's do 3. They're just gonna share all that space for the time being. As soon as that is up, we would also like to build a small storage for all those items that we have. Well, maybe not so small. Let's do something that's a bit more average, I suppose. Could put a window here as well, just to make it a little bit nicer. I mean, it's not going to be a permanent solution, so... let's just put a couple of things down. And with this section here as well, let's do... Let's see, wicker roof. Which way is it? This way. Alright, we'll slap a roof over their heads as well. So they'll feel nice and cozy in there. Same thing with our storage. Yep, it's gonna be too small, but you know what? I think we can leave the wood and sticks outside. But everything else will be staying inside for sure. Right, so we'll extend the roofing just through there. And I think for the time being, let's just hide it all. Default stockpile, let's place you down here. And what we'll do is, let's take off, let's see. We don't want any waste in here. What else do we not want? Materials. Let's take the materials off as well. Cool, okay, so that's being built. Now, the next 2 things we're gonna need is to start producing some science, but also some food. So let's do a campfire. We'll put it on the rocks over here, so we're not going to burn the rest of the ground. Which, in the game, obviously it doesn't matter. But, we'll just put it on the rocks over there instead. Right, it is 1 o'clock, so we still have some time to build things. We should have enough resources. Yes, we do. So how about... How big does it have to be? Not too big. I guess we could... Maybe... let's bring it up again. Let's do... I guess something like this. Nope. And this could be our... science area. But the roof is gonna be a little bit awkward. You know what? That's okay. We won't put the roofing here. Let's do it slightly differently. We'll just put a floor on top of this one. Alright. And we are also gonna need a door in here and, well, probably a window would be nice as well. So that way when the good-looking gamer is producing us some signs, he's not gonna feel all so lonely. You can still see outside. For the floor, don't have many sticks, but we gotta... Wait, let's actually check. Okay, yeah, we don't have a whole lot of sticks, so... Let's just use wood instead. And that should be pretty perfect. Do you know what? We'll actually also demolish this, so they'll start hopefully hauling some stuff around. And maybe we'll just cut a few more trees down as well, so we have a bit more space in here. Yep, that should be good. Alright, let's speed this up a little bit. Nope. And if we bring the levels down just a little bit. Now the basic research table. Yeah, let's just put it right under the window there. And with the rest, we'll turn this into a stockpile. Off, let's see, clear everything. We're just gonna have books in here. So the way research works in this game is you aren't producing research, but by writing books, different types of books. There was three different ones, if I remember correctly. And you have to keep them safe, because if they get damaged or broken or stolen, then you're gonna lose that research. So let's get this table up so we can have a look at what we can do here as well. It seems like the evening is approaching rather quickly. So we are gonna want to produce some chronicles. Let's just do maybe 50 for starters should be enough. And if we look at this here, we've already got 25 chronicles. And architecture is gonna cost us 15, so we'll unlock this. And you know what, let's set this on a very high priority as well. Yeah. Alright, bring the books in, please. Can we also bring all this stuff in? Right, so same for the food. We are gonna put a few... Well, not few. We can only do meals, so let's do until we have... Yeah, then should be pretty good. We can harvest a few berries and mushrooms just in the area. So it's actually quite a good starting location here. Yeah, what's your problem? Probably resources, most likely. Great, Pixie, what are you doing there? Oh yeah, we're just moving stuff around. Okay, cool. Bolly is already busy harvesting some mushrooms. And I think it's evening time now, so everyone's gonna have a quick nap. Right, so that's a couple of things already done. Let's see what else we can do. They also have some needs, so if we... Let's see, we'll take the good-looking gamer. Right, so deprived of religious activities, so we'll create a couple of rooms in here where they can satisfy their need for the said things. Now, where should we put it? This might be our... Nah. Do you know what? Let's just do it up here. Yeah, maybe we'll pull it from this way. Don't think the room had to be too big. This seems like the middle, roughly. Yep, that should be good. We'll put a couple of doors on as well. And there's two different religions. Let's see, which one are you guys? Not under health mood. Nope. You know what? I can't remember where to check this from. Ah, there we go. Religious alignment. So, Oak, Brethren, Zealot. Okay. What about Pauly? Same. Pixie. Okay, so they're all... Both are... Well, all three are pretty much the same, so that's great. Then that means we'll only have to put one of you down. And I guess we'll do it just over here. Great. Which means in that one, can we put this here? Yes, we can. So that should give them a bit of fun as well. Oh no, you're gonna be stuck now. Yep. So we shall put a set of stairs. Just, you know what, Pauly, can you prioritize this actually? Otherwise, where's Pixie? Oh no, Pixie's down here. Okay, I thought he's gonna be stuck. Yeah, so we've got a bit of a balcony here as well. Oh. Oh, okay. So I guess the fence does not turn automatically, or does it? No, it doesn't. Never mind. We'll just leave it then. At least for now. How much food do we still have? Only 6 package meals left. So let's check the jobs again. Cooking is gonna be important. Hmm. So if you're the researcher, you got 11. But you know what? You're gonna be the cook. And then you'll do growing, harvesting, and cutting the plants. That actually means, let's see, we are gonna need agriculture, so that way we can start generating some crops in here as well. So let's do, we've got cabbage, we've got flax, carrots, beets, barley, herbs, red currants, tall grass, and some trees. Great, so let's do, we'll do just small batches over here, maybe something like that. Flax, no, let's do some carrots. And what was this one? Beet field. Couple of these down as well. And well, we are gonna need some herbs, just in case for healing purposes later, but also for better meals, if I remember correctly. Right. We are also gonna need some more wood, I think. You know what? Let's do another stockpile here. I think we'll put it back here, actually. Let's clear all, and we're gonna have materials in here. Ooh, mechanical components. Do you know what? 10 years, that's a long time. So we can just leave it out there. Right, let's speed up the time a little bit. And hopefully, I think we'll remove the roofs for now. Yeah. So it's gonna be easier to see what's happening inside. Yep, let's do that. Okay, good looking gamer. How many have you made already? Only 7. Well, that's okay. We only need, what should we go next? We could go tailoring. That's gonna be, ooh, 20 of those. Cartography, I don't think we really need the map just yet. Preserving food would be nice though. Get some shelves. But I'm also thinking maybe stone blocks and clay bricks would be fantastic as well. Yeah. Then we can start heading upwards. Don't want to focus in this area for too long. Especially perfecting everything in here, if we are gonna build our colony up here. But the reason why we're mostly doing it down here right now is I don't want our initial buildings to be in the way. So right now, it's gonna be a little bit easier to figure out exactly the measurements and where we want things to go. Right, it is 7 in the PM again. And now we see Pixie finally planting some, what do we have here, cabbage. Okay, that's good. How long is this gonna take? 4 days, okay, so that's pretty quick. And Polly seems to be bringing us some stuff there. Great, how about we cut down a few more trees? Well, we got some logs, but not a whole lot of sticks, it seems. Maybe a few more of those trees so we can actually see what's underneath here. And to be honest, this spot here is not bad at all because we got walls all around. If we build a couple more walls here, this place will be pretty good to defend against raiders. Yeah, it's not bad at all because I think if we go through here... Oh, they can go through, so we could put a few walls just over there. Then if we zoom out, we can do the same in here. Or maybe leave this and turn it into a choke point. Yeah, that could work. But then we might just have to cut a few more things in here so we can see and turn this into a some kind of an archer tower. Well, let's not get too ahead of ourselves, because this is only supposed to be a temporary area. And, let's see, what else have you done here, Pixie? We've got some carrots as well. 6 days for those. Thought you've already planted them. I guess he has to fix them up. Well, that's fine. Alright, we've got some meals that have been done for us as well. So we've got some stew. But now it seems we don't have enough plants to make any more. Alright, let's try and harvest. Well, we got a few berries here. And that, how about cutting down a couple of these as well? Oh no, now they're gonna have to go all the way around, isn't it? Well, do you know what? Let's fix this. Let's put another set of snares. But for the time being, we'll just cancel this order. And this one. Why is that last piece of roof not built? What are we missing? Wood. Polly? Need to clear area. Oh. Well. For some reason, they don't want to let me do this in here. Do you know what? Maybe we'll cancel this roof. Maybe we can run through. Can we now cut this tree down? Or I reckon it's just too young. It has to grow up just a little bit, so then we can demolish that. Okay. Let's clean up this area just a little bit more. I think we'll give them a slightly larger task to clear as many trees as we can. Just a very, very difficult to see what's happening in this whole area. So that should do. And let's see how the good-looking gamer... Okay, so 33 left. I think we'll add another 10. Just need a few more. And then we should be able to research our next level things. Okay, great. Let's take the roofs off again. Have we... Oh, that tree... is missing now. Well, that's actually really, really good. It means we can put this roof down again. Now, which way is it? It's very difficult to see it this way. Perfect. There we go. Oh. Got some rain now as well. Let's get this roof on. Here we go. Big is on the task. And Paulie's gonna help him out as well, so we get this done rather quickly. Now the last thing we are planting here is beets. That's gonna take slightly longer, but well, it doesn't really tell us how many beets do we get per tile, but perhaps it's gonna be a slightly larger harvest compared to cabbages. Could we please bring in those mushroom piles as well, please? Or what's happening here? Let's scroll down. Food. Yep, yeah, it's all ticked. Maybe medium. Actually, we'll make a couple more meals here. How many days is this gonna last? About 17 to 24 before it decomposes. And that's because of the temperature. It's just too warm outside. And that leads me actually to the general plan with this colony as well. I know towards the world's end game we should have some more advanced raids where some sort of catapults and yeah, I think it was some kind of catapults that should come here, and they are gonna launch projectiles at your colony, and if it hits your walls or whatever it is, then they are gonna get destroyed pretty quickly, and that can be quite annoying, especially when you have a multi-level some sort of a castle, let's say, because if the bottom floors, let's say it's 5 levels high and the bottom levels and walls and floors get destroyed, then with the stability and how that works, it might bring down quite a large chunk of your building as well, if it's not planned and built, I guess, well, when it isn't designed very well. So I was thinking we might become the mob people and hide in the underground, because I have not heard that those catapults, well, those projectiles, that they destroy the land. I might be wrong. If you know more about this, do let me know. But that was part of the reason. I mean, we'll definitely be building some things underground, because we want to have some sort of a cellar to keep our food from rotting as well. Yeah. For sure. Alright, let's cut a few more things in here, so we can get some. How many more days is this? 41 days. Okay, so that's not bad at all. Pixie. Do you know what, Pixie? I think you're gonna be our main hauler for a little while. Yeah. Just move things around, please. And while you look at that, they've taken down pretty much all the trees in this area. So that's pretty amazing. Carry on, young soldiers. Good looking beaver, what are you up to? Just having a quick snack break. Okay, that's fine. 34 left. Alright, so research available. What shall we do next? I reckon stone blocks. Or brewing, furniture. Furniture would be nice actually as well. Maybe stone blocks. Better clothes, preserving food. Go hunting and make some smoked meat. Ah, so many good things. Brewing as well, so we could make some drinks. Do you know what? We'll get the brewing. And we'll add a few more books in there. What we'll do is... I can already feel we're gonna start expanding quite a bit, aren't we? You know what? So be it. It's fine. It's okay. We'll take this out. We'll It just would. I mean, it's okay. Don't really want to expand, but we're gonna do it anyways. Right, so our first event. Got a friendly visit from a lone traveler. And how far are you? Okay, so you might want to trade with us. But I don't think we have a lot of things to trade with you. Which is okay. Do you know what? I think this could be a bit of a corridor here. We got more logs. So... yeah, I think it's gonna be... something like... we'll try and mirror it. There's still a window here as well. And a couple more floors. Yeah. Okay, so that means we can put down the brewing station. I suppose somewhere here would be nice. Hopefully it's not gonna burn down the whole building, but yeah, that should be fine. We'll make this building just a little bit bigger. Oh, no, that's not what we wanted to do. And a couple more windows as well. Yeah, let's do it this way. And floors. Of course, the floors. Here we go. Because the next thing we did want to do is let's give them a small table so they can have a nice, lovely meal and actually sit and eat from the table. Beautiful. It is going to need a roof, but I think we'll just do the wood floor here. Oh yeah, almost forgot about the stability. This is too wide, so this means... let's see... 1, 2, 3... Oh, it's just one off, but that's... that's okay. We'll do the wooden beams. Here, here... and here as well. And now we should be able to place the floor, if only we could see. Fantastic, and we'll speed up the time as well since it's evening. So I think tomorrow we should have this built. Research. Yep, Paulie's gonna be constructing all that. He's gonna be a busy man for quite some time. But we do have more than enough resources, so it should not be a problem at all. Awesome. Hopefully we're not gonna get too many raids right off the... right at the start. But... yeah, that's quite a good start for our colony. So what we are gonna do now... let's see where the merchant is. Who was our best... trader? Okay, so good looking gamer. You're gonna barter, see what we can trade. Alright, so what can we buy from you? Ooh, you got some lavish meals and some alcohol. Well, take all this. What would you like to buy? Hmm. Well, there isn't a whole lot of things to sell. But I guess we could give him some food. Let's do a few of those stews. And maybe some linen cloth as well. You know what? No, let's do just the meals. And that seems to be a good amount, so let's do that. Fantastic. So we can always cook some more. Oh, wait. Cooking material. Okay, we're gonna have to start harvesting some things that we can find in the forest. Do you know what? We'll also allow you to pick up all this stuff from here. Cool. Oh, quick autosave and harvest all this as well, please. All right, so this has been quite a long episode already. We shall carry on in the next one, and I'm hoping that we'll start constructing a few things up here as well. Ooh, there's a lot of berries in here. But yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again in the next one.